All right, Shalom. This is Brother Daniela coming back again with another lesson through the Spirit. Giving all praises to Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi, by Hashem Arakak Wadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. And Shalom to the hopeful elect brethren, teaching and pushing this word in sincerity and in truth. Shalom. So this is just going to be a video on, you know, the Lord is going to bring, you know, violence. The Lord is going to bring destruction. All right. He's going to bring the sword. All right. And that's going into this first scripture here, Matthew 10 and 34. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. Right. So as you can see, I got this picture of a depiction. Okay. Of Yahawashi. Okay. What I mean by depiction as a, of what he looked like, the features and characteristics he has, right? And they're all based according to, you know, the scriptures, okay? So, right, and as you can see, he has a sword in his hand. Now, this is the Son of the Most High, man. This is the Son of the Heavenly Father, Yahawah, right? And the Lord says in the scriptures that he's going to bring destruction upon Esau, Edom, and these other nations, right? And it's evident through the scriptures, man. So this, you know, when all else fails, you gotta go back to the scriptures, because this is what the scriptures say, that he's going to bring destruction, right? Now we're going to go to Isaiah, right? We're going to go to Isaiah chapter 66 and verse 15, right? It says, "For behold, the Lord will come with fire," all right? And you see that's Lord with all caps, so it's talking about the Heavenly Father, Yahawah. Of course, sending his son Yahawashi. So Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi. It says, "For behold, the Lord will come with fire and his chariots like a whirlwind." All right. His chariots, so-called UFOs. Right. As they call them, unidentified aerial phenomena. Right, so-called UFOs, okay, spaceships, starships, okay, to render his anger with fury and his rebukes with flames of fire, right? So this is in the scriptures. The Lord is going to come and he's going to bring the destruction upon Esau, Edom, and the rest of these nations, right? He's going to come with fire, okay? It says, "For by fire and by his sword, okay, will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many," right? So the Lord is going to destroy a lot of people, right? According to Zephaniah, the 13th chapter in the 8th verse, he's going to destroy 2/3 of the house of Israel. So you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, right? And any other Israelites who may look like the other nations that go back to the seed line of Israel, all right? Who are 2/3, man, who will be rejected in this time, man, right? Who are not of the elect, because, and we're going to get it, the Lord is going to, you know, he's going to save his elect of Israel. It says, I read 17, it says, "They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst, eating swine's flesh, and the abomination and the mouse shall be consumed together, saith the Lord." Right? So, hey, that poses the question. If the law was done away with and you could eat whatever you want, you could do whatever you want, you don't have to follow anything, any of the laws, statutes, commandments that Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi has given us and commanded that we should follow, why is he going to destroy people eating swine's flesh? Right? And the abomination, any other abominable animal, lobster, crabs, shrimp, right? And the mouse shall be consumed together, saith the Lord, right? So they're going to be consumed by fire, right? And this fire is going to be coming out of the chariots of the Most High, all right? So let me go to Matthew's 24th chapter, just to prove that the Lord's coming to save his elect, right? This is Matthew's 24, and I'm going to start at, this is verse 29. Verse 30, it says, and then shall the sign of the Son of Man, Salakia, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and they shall all, then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. They shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. Right? Now, when it says the clouds of heaven, that's just, you know, that's just what the scriptures, how they refer to his heavenly vehicles, you know, the chariots. Okay, your so-called UFOs, which you see them on the news. You know, you got Esau talking about it on these different, they call it ancient aliens, right? Which, you know, they're not aliens. They're the angels, okay, that fly in these heavenly vehicles, all right? That do these phenomenal aerial things, okay, in the air. And the Lord's showing his chariots all over the world, man. He's making his presence known, okay? It says, I'll read it again. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming with the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. So when Yahawashi, when the Most High sends Yahawashi back to destroy this place, he's coming with power and great glory, right? He's coming back as an angelic force, man. And we, you know, Lord willing, we're going to get that scripture. It says, and he shall send his angels, right, with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect, okay, from the four winds, from one end of the earth, of heaven, to the other, right? So he's going to gather all the scattered Israelites, the elect men, women, and children of Israel, okay, right, to receive this salvation, okay? So Yahawashi is coming back with those chariots, and we're going to get what he's going to do, right? Because just as we read, think not that I come to send peace upon the earth, man. Yahawashi is coming back to send destruction, man. He's coming back for war, right? Let me get that scripture. How does that one go again? Salaki, bros. Try to quote this. Get the scripture. If it don't fade away out of my mind. Judges. Right here. All right. This is Revelation chapter 19. Hold on. Let me read Revelation chapter 19. I'm going to start at verse 10. It says, and I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, see thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahawashi. Worship the Most High, for the testimony of Yahawashi is the spirit of prophecy. Right. So that's what we do, you know, here at Great Millstone. You know, that's what we do, and that's the example we follow from our apostles, is to go out and to prophesy, to tell Israel what's coming, man. And what's coming is not peaceful. What's coming is destruction, right? And that's how you could tell the difference between a real prophet, okay, and a phony, man, a false prophet, right? Example, these pork chop eating pastors. They're saying peace and prosperity and all of this when, you know, according to the book of Isaiah, I believe the 28th chapter in the 8th verse, it says the prophets before me have prophesied against many great many kingdoms of war and evil and pestilence, right? So peace is not coming, right? Violence, all right, by way of Yahawah, by Hashem Yahawashi, according to the scriptures, okay, is coming. And it's coming upon America. And it's coming upon the nation of Esau, you know, the so-called white man, or the so-called Caucasians, all right, and the rest of these nations. We're going to get more scriptures to prove that, according to the scriptures, man. I'm going to continue reading. It says 11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war. So this is talking about Yahawashi, right? So when he comes back, he's coming back to judge, and he's coming back to make war, right? That doesn't sound like peace to me, man, right? And these are the scriptures, right? Right, if you speak not according to this word, there is no light in you, right? Light meaning wisdom, knowledge, okay? So now I want to go to Isaiah, right? Because this is another prophecy that hasn't come to pass yet. I want to go to Isaiah chapter 63, and I'm going to start at verse 1. It says, who is this that come from Edom, right? So, in this prophecy, someone's coming from Edom, right? It says, with dyed garments from Bozrah, right? Which is the, I believe when you look up Bozrah, that's the, if we look it up real quick, dyed garments from Bozrah. Bozrah, I believe that's the chief city of Edom. Bozrah. Right, here you go. It says Bozrah city. It says Nabatea. Bozrah was the capital city of the Edomites. There you go. Right there. Bozrah was the capital city of the Edomites once they settled from their nomadic lifestyle. Right? So, who is this that come from Edom? Right? Who is this that come from Edom? Which is so-called white people. With dyed garments from Bozrah, this that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength. I that speak righteousness, mighty to save. Right? So, this is Yahawashi. Right? He's mighty to save and speaking righteousness, man. It says, Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, in thy garments like him that treadeth the wine fat? Right, so when you look at guys who stomp grapes, you know, when they're stomping on those grapes, the grapes are splattering all over their clothing. It's like they have blood on them, right? So that's why he says wore thou red in their apparel, right? So that's symbolic for all the bloodshed and the destruction that Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi is going to bring. All right? It says, verse 3, I have trodden the winepress alone, and of the people, there was none with me. It says, for I will tread them in mine anger and trample them in my fury. Right? So, just as we read, man, the Lord will plead with all flesh, man. The slain of the Lord shall be many. So this is violence from Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi, from the God of the Bible, through his son, right, and his holy angels. It says,
and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments. There you go, right? It's breaking it down. And I will stain all my raiment. For the day of vengeance is in mine heart, and the year of my redeemer is come. So Yahawashi has the day of vengeance, right? Payback, right? In his mind. When you look up the word heart, it goes back to the word lab in Hebrew, meaning mind. It says, and I looked, and there was none to help, and I wondered that there was none to uphold. Therefore, mine own arm brought salvation unto me, and my fury it upheld me. And I will tread down the people in mine anger, and I will make them drunk with my fury. Right? So this is from Yahawah Ba'ashim Yahawashi, and we're reading it according to the scriptures. Right? It says, and I will bring down their strength to the earth. Right? And that's the point, man. So Yahawashi is coming back for mass destruction, man. Right? By way of those chariots. So he's going to be getting busy. Right? Destroying people. Right? Destroying, you know, judging and making war. Destroying the wicked and saving the elect. As we got in Matthew's the 24th chapter. All right? Now, I'm going to go to another chapter because that you know, all that bloodshed, that's all symbolic, because with those chariots, man, they're going to be breathing out fire. So people are going to be getting obliterated, man. Decimated, turned into powder, right? Let me get this. Utterly beaten into powder. Right, because when you set something on fire, you get, you know, soot, ashes, you know, which is like powder, Salakia. Let me see if I can find it. Salakia, I don't think I can find it at the moment. Right, so we're going to go to this next scripture here. I'm going to salak you for that. This is 2 Ezra chapter 13. We're going to start at verse 1. Because this is another, you know, prophecy, you know, given to Ezra that he saw. Right, so it says another vision. Okay, it says, and it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there arose a wind from the sea, and it moved all the waves thereof. And I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven. Right? So Yahawashi said in Matthew's 24th chapter that you shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven. Right? The thousands of heaven. Talking about all those chariots with those angels, man. And when he turned his countenance to look, all things trembled that were seen under him. Right? Back to 24, Matthew 24 again. He said all the tribes of the earth shall mourn. Right? Because when they see Yahawashi coming with that power, hey, people are going to be in awe. Right? They're going to be in fear, and they're going to be amazed at what they're seeing, man. That glory.
right? It says, and whensoever his voice went out of his mouth, out of these chariots, all they burned that heard his voice, like as the earth faileth when it feeleth the fire, man. So the fire is going to be coming out of these chariots, man. Intense, heavenly fire going to be coming out, man, destroying things. And after this, I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea. Right? So Esau, you know, and these other nations, man, they're going to try to fight Yahawashi, right? Chiefly Esau, man. He's going to try to fight Yahawashi, right? You know, and that's why in Revelation it said that, and there was war in heaven, man. Right? Esau and his military fighting against the Lord and his army, man. Right? In the heavens. You know? With their air force. It says, but I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew upon it. But I would have seen the region or place where the hill was graven. And I could not, right? So basically saying, you know, his chariot was as big as a mountain, man. It was huge. Right? So he's coming in that fathership, man. And after this, I beheld, and lo, all they that were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid, but durst fight. Right? Right? So these armies, man, they're going to be afraid to fight Yahawashi, man. But the Lord's going to put the spirit on them to still fight. Right? To make the battle, you know, interesting somewhat. Because, you know, as you're about to see, man, the Lord's about to have all these people decimated, man. Destroyed. It says, and lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lifted up hand nor sword, Shalak, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war. Right? So this is the point I wanted to get to, coming from Isaiah 63. Right? All that blood upon his garment. It's not really talking about blood upon his garment, because when he comes back with the chariots, he's not gonna have to use a sword, right? And these chariots, he's, you know, I don't know however he's gonna do it, whether he says a command or he thinks it or however, but at his command, right? Them chariots are gonna blow out fire, man. Laser beams, intense heat. Right? It says, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth, as it had been, a blast of fire. Right? This is violence from the Lord. Okay? This is destruction and evil from Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi. It says, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests. Right? And they were all mixed together, Salakia. And they were all mixed together, and the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and a great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude. All right, these people who came up against him, which were prepared to fight, and burnt them up every one, so that upon a sudden, right, upon a sudden. Of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived but only dust and the smell of smoke. When I saw this, I was afraid, right? So Ezra was freaked out by what was going on, man, by this vision, man, because that's how great and terrible and powerful Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi is coming with that vengeance, man, just as we read, with that destruction, with that judgment. Right? In a split second, this whole multitude, you know, thousands and thousands, maybe even millions of soldiers, right? Gone. Turned into powder.
by way of that fire, man, them laser beams. Okay? Now, I'm going to go here also to Habakkuk, the third chapter. Right? And Habakkuk, the third chapter, but I'm going to have to get this other Bible app here just to prove, you know, these chariots there. You know, they're shooting out laser beams. So this is Habakkuk chapter 3. And rise, remember mercy. I'm going to start at verse 1. It says, a prayer of Habakkuk the prophet upon Shigionoth. The Lord, I have heard, O Lord, I have heard thy speech and was afraid. O Lord, revive thy work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make known. In wrath, remember mercy. Right? So just as I said before, man, you know, Yahawashi, Yahawashi, you know, he's a power of balance. Okay, so, you know, when there's destruction happening, there's going to be salvation also. Salvation for the elect and destruction for the two-thirds and the rest of the wicked and these other nations, man. So, you know, he's praying that the Lord will have mercy in his wrath also, right? It says, in wrath, remember mercy. The Most High came from Teman. Now, Teman, right? So notice in Isaiah, the 63rd chapter, it said he came from Edom, right? From Bozra. Now it's saying he came from Teman. Now, where is Teman? Or who is Teman? It says the son of Elipaz, grandson of Esau, one of the dukes of Edom, right? Tribe descended from one noted for wisdom of its people, right? So, yeah, Teman is known for being the wise of Esau, which, you know, would be those so-called Germans, okay? With all their technological advances and knowledge. It says, the region occupied by the descendants of one located east of Idumea, right? So this is all dealing with Edom, right? It says, the Most High came from Teman, right? The Most High came from Edom with, you know, with his dyed garments from Bozra. And the Holy One from Mount Paran, Selah. His glory covered the heavens and the earth was full of his praise, right? So his glory was covered the heavens, man. These chariots are going to be all over the sky, right? With that brightness and that glory, man. It says, and his brightness was as the light, and he had horns coming out of his hand. And there was the hiding of his power, right? So, you know, we read scriptures where it says he's going to plead by fire, man. He's going to punish people by fire. That's when you go into that word plead, when you look it up in the Hebrew, right? So, we're going to get the word horns here in verse 4. It says, quarun. It says, horn of strength, figuratively. It says, a flask, container of oil, horn as a musical instrument. It says, horn. It says, of horn-like projections on the altar. It says, of rays of light. Rays of light. Another word for rays of light, laser beams, right? A beam is another, is a synonym for ray. So, laser beams, man. Right? Out of his hands came horns. And there was the power, man, that fire. Laser beams from his chariots. Before him, verse 5, before him went the pestilence of burning coals and went for fire at his feet. He stood and measured the earth, and he beheld and drove asunder the nations, and the everlasting mountains were scattered. The perpetual hills did bow his presence. Let me read that again. The perpetual hills did bow, his ways are everlasting. Let me keep reading. It says, I saw the tents of Cushan in affliction, and the curtains of the land of Midian did tremble. Right? So you know, these different nations in these different places where these people are at, people are going to be trembling, man. There's going to be much affliction, much violence from Yahawah Bahashim Yahawashi. Okay? It says, was the Lord displeased against the rivers? Was his anger against the rivers? Was thy wrath against the sea? That thou didst ride upon thine horses, okay, and thy chariots of salvation. So that's, you know, that's talking about, you know, these so-called UFOs. All right. So, hey, man, the Lord's coming with violence, man. He's coming with judgment and vengeance, man. Right. To plead for the cause of the nation of Israel. Right. Against Edom and these other nations, man, because. What is 1 Thessalonians, Salaki, not 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, the first chapter, and verse 6 say, man? It says, seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you, right? So that's why Yahawashi said he's coming with vengeance, man, right? Because we've been troubled and we had much tribulation, much affliction by Esau, Edom, man. By way of the Atlantic slave trade, being slaves, being massacred upon the arrival of Cristobal Colon, okay, or Christopher Columbus, right, to all the Israelites who are in South America and the Americas before, you know, the so-called Negroes came over here, which was the tribe of Judah, Benjamin and Levi, okay? You know, the Lord's going to plead for the cause of Israel. Right, and that's written in Joel, the third chapter. You can read that. Okay, so more scriptures, because the sword is coming from Yahawah Bahashim Yahawashi. Vengeance is coming from Yahawah Bahashim Yahawashi. And he's going to give his men, right, his elect men, okay, the power to take, to be a part of that vengeance, man. Right, but first and foremost, Yahawashi is going to bring it, man. He has the vengeance in his heart, and he's going to allow his servants, his faithful servants, to take part in it also. So, to get that vengeance. So, now we're going to go to Psalms. We're going to go to, what is it? We're going to go to Psalms 137, because Esau thinks, you know, that, you know, the Lord's not going to get violent with him. That the Lord's not going to render unto him what they did unto us. Right? So, now get this. This is Psalms 137. I'm going to start at verse 1. Okay? And then I'm going to hop down to, I believe, verse 6 or 8. So you can get the point. Because, you know, these Edomites, they come in that spirit and that vibration of the ancient Babylonians, okay, of the ancient Romans, the ancient Greeks, the ancient Egyptians, man, the ancient Assyrians, they come in that same vibrations, okay, as it pertains to their demonology and their witchcraft, all right, and the worshiping of those different idols from those ancient empires, okay, so this is Psalms 137 and 1. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yea, we wept when we remembered Zion. Okay? So, notice it says by the rivers of Babylon. Now, this is talking about America. Okay? America, Babylon the Great. Okay? It says, we hang our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there they that carried us away captive, right? I just said the Atlantic slave trade required of us a song, okay? And they that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion, right? So us going into slavery, man. And you can see a good example of how we're being beaten to death, man, whipped, put in chains,
having our women raped, which is, these are all a part of the curses that are put upon us. Okay? But all done by who? Esau, Edom. Right? You so-called white people, man. Right? You can see a good example in that movie, 12 Years a Slave, where, you know, here it is, you're a slave, you're getting your ass beat every day, right? You're getting worked to death, and they want you to get up and play the violin and dance and sing to be their entertainment, right? So I'm going to jump down here. It says, now, remember, it said Babylon. Now, let's get to verse 7, because Babylon in this chapter does not represent the actual Babylonians. Okay, it says, remember, O Lord, the children of Edom, right? Adawam, meaning red, because you so-called Caucasians, you so-called white people are not white, you're red. In the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof, right? Raise it meaning destroy it, okay? O daughter of Babylon, right? Daughter of Babylon, right? O daughter of Babylon, right? Also known as daughter of the Chaldeans, right? Because they come in that same stead or that same spirit of the ancient Babylonians. Because who ought to be destroyed? Who ought to be destroyed? Okay? Happy shall he be that rewarded thee as thou hast served us, right? So it says, remember Edom. Edom is who? The daughter of Babylon. Where's Babylon? America, right? Babylon meaning confusion. This is the place of confusion. You got all these nations mixed up. You got all these different idols all over the place, right? All these different decrees and madness, right? Because Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi's laws and statutes and commandments are not being upheld here. So you get all this confusion and disorder, right? This is the place of confusion, all right? It says, happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones, right? So, let me read verse 8 again. O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, happy shall he be that rewardeth thee as thou hast served us, right? So there's no getting out of the vengeance of Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi. There's no getting out of you other nations in Esau, Edom, going into slavery. It's written in the scriptures. It's written in the scriptures, man. And this judgment is going to be executed upon you, man. And upon your children. Thus saith the Bible. Not from my own mind, not from what we think, but thus saith the Bible. Okay, happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. Right? Now, we're going to go from there. We're going to go to we're going to go to Psalms 149. Okay, and we'll start at verse 1. It says, praise ye Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praises in the congregation of the saints. Who are the saints? The Israelites. Okay? And that's proven in Psalms 147. It says, let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto him with the timbrel and the harp. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people, does it say peoples there? Nah, it says his people, one, the Israelites, and he will beautify the meek with salvation, right? So the humble, you know, the poor, he will beautify the meek with salvation. It says, let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds, right? It says, let the high praises of the Most High be in their mouth, right? So they're going to be praising Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi, right? And a two-edged sword in their hand. Now, what's that sword going to be for, man? It says to execute vengeance upon the heathen. Let's look up the word vengeance, man. Right? Now, this is written. This is written. Right? This is the word of Yahawah Bashim Yahawashi. This is written. Okay? And what does the scripture say? It says, let the Most High be true and every man a liar. So this is the truth. Right? Numbers, I believe, 20:23, where it says, you know, if that the Lord hath said it, shall he not make it good? Right? The Lord is not a man that he should lie. So this is going to happen, man. Vengeance is going to be a wrought on these other nations. Chiefly Esau, Edom. The Lord is going to have vengeance for his people. You know? Salakia. The word vengeance in the Hebrew is nakwama. It says vengeance. Vengeance by the Most High, by Israel, by enemies of Israel. It says avengement. It says whether the act of passion, avenge, revenge, right? Vengeance. Now hold on. Let's get a deeper understanding of that. Just gonna look this up here, Salakia. What time is it? Alright. So let's get the word vengeance here in the etymology dictionary. Salakia. Let's get revenge then. Because it said revenge also. Venge. Alright, so here we got the word revenge. Let's get that noun. Right, vengeance, revenge. So the word revenge, says late 14th century from old French, revenger, variant of revencher, to take vengeance, avenge. It says 13th century modern French, revencher, from re, intensive prefix re. Right, which re means again, it says, venger, to take revenge. Latin, vindicare, to claim, all right, to avenge, to punish, right? See vindication. It says to avenge is to get revenge, to take vengeance. It suggests the administration of just, right, meaning righteous punishment for a criminal or immoral act. For a criminal or immoral act, right? So, what was this criminal or immoral act that Esau, Edom did unto the children of Israel? Right? Let's get it in the scriptures. We're going to go back up to here so I can have that other scripture saved on that app. Let's get it. Found in his hand. All right, so this is Exodus chapter 21 and verse 16. It says, and he that stealeth a man and selleth him, or if he be found in his hand, he shall surely be put to death. Right, so the Atlantic slave trade. Who was stolen? Right, the Israelites, man. Right, the so-called Negroes. Okay, and the so-called Jews, I mean the Jews, Salakia, as in Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, they were stolen from where? From Western and Central Africa, man, in different parts of Africa where they dwelt, right? Which that's where we fled in 70 AD. And they brought us over here for slavery, man.
They stole us. They bought us. Right? Stole us and sold us on the auctioning blocks, man. Okay? So this is the judgment of what is going to happen to Esau, Edom, man. Right? They're going to get, you know, hey, man, like, let's get it, man. Right? Because we were led into what? Captivity. Right? We were led into captivity. So what we're hoping for, man, by doing this work maintaining this faith in Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi, is that we will live to see our enemies going to captivity under us. Okay? This is Revelation chapter 13 and 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. All right? You so-called Caucasians, white people, Edomites, led us into captivity. Okay? Chiefly, the tribe of Judah. All right? And the Benjaminites, which are the West Indians, so-called West Indians, and the Levites, the so-called Haitians. Right? And also, the Northern Kingdom also, man. Enslaved. Brought on slave ships unto Europe, man, to Spain. Them too. Right, they're Israelites also. The so-called Latinos. So-called Native Americans. Right? He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. And that's how Esau gets down, man. That's his blessing in Genesis, the 27th chapter, man. Right? By way of Isaac, who was Yahawashi in the reincarnation. So, you know, Yahawashi gave Esau Edom his blessing of the sword, but now Yahawashi is coming with the sword, right? Meaning destruction to take away Esau's power, man. Okay, here is the patience and the faith of the saints. So this is what we were suffering for. Right? And this is what we have faith in, to see the fall of our enemies. Okay? So, hey, man, I just did this, you know, through the Spirit, just wanted to do this video to prove that, you know, Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi, he's bringing the violence. He's bringing the evil, man. Right? He's bringing the destruction. Okay? And you know, for any nation to be established, right, as you can see throughout the scriptures and throughout history, okay, there was always violence for one nation to gain power and to have peace for a period of time, right? And the Lord sets up all these different nations. He's going to set up Israel, right? Just as the scriptures say, the Lord ruleth in the kingdom of men, all right? So with that, you know, I want to give all praises to Yahawah Hashem Yahawashi, Hashem Abrakak Wadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone, and Shalom to the hopeful elect brethren, teaching and pushing his word in sincerity and in truth. Shalom.